What's happening, everybody? It's your boy RePPiN. Welcome back to another video. I'm gonna be really brief with this, but I just want to kind of give y'all my thoughts and opinions about the Nintendo Direct. Basically, my impressions. So here we go. Foremost, I enjoyed the new layout that they did. I'm not gonna try to say the main guy who was presenting everything. The name. I'll probably put it in the description below. But I liked it. I enjoyed it. Hope they keep doing it the way they're doing it like that. They kind of show some games here and there, then get to the point, then show some games here and there, and be very brief about it. That's what it's all about. You know, they were direct, they report about it. The biggest things, it was like the meat and potatoes of this whole thing, was ARMS as well as Splatoon 2. And let me start off the top, because there's three things that really interested me, you know, this whole thing. Not saying nothing else I was really digging or feeling, but let me explain to y'all this. So, number one, ARMS. I loved what they showcased. I had a feeling this was coming. I should have made a video on it, but I didn't. And I would have been so right if I did. I'm so mad I didn't. But it's going to have an in-game currency system. They didn't say if we're going to be using microtransactions, which I hope we don't. I mean, this is the type of game I feel like eventually it might happen, but from the start, I feel like it'd be something that people need to earn so they can get their little power-ups, the little elemental specials and stuff, etc., character gear, whatnot, you know. But I do like that they showcase it's gonna be a 2v2 mode included with the game. You can swap up your equipment. They added a new character unveiled a new character named Min Min, who's made of ramen. Love me some ramen, y'all. But yeah, man, they showcased a lot of details with ARMS, and I'm really digging it. And I can't wait for it to come out. Now, on the next thing, we'll talk about Splatoon 2. Now, as y'all know, they showcased a new horde mode called Summon Run. That one map they showcased where they were like on an oil rig in the middle of the ocean, or like some sort of like little fishing dock or someplace like that. Basically, what I'm saying is, I hope that's not the only map. I hope there's other maps included. I wouldn't mind it, but I mean, it would be nice to have different varieties of maps to be able to play this mode on. It looks like it's going to deliver an awesome experience. Plenty of rewards, it looks like. It's going to be one of those. You get rewarded for it as long as your teamwork. And teamwork does look like it's needed. So hopefully when people play that, they're not just doing their own thing. Like, yeah, I'm a badass, I'm going to go this way. Don't do that. Play it team-based, because that's what Splatoon is all about. I like it. It's an addition. It looks like it's going to be something I can actually get into and hang out with the homies. I'm not going to get Splatoon 2 at launch, but I will get it eventually. But I mean, that's just something that's cool. A lot of people look like they're enjoying it. So yeah. Now on to my last thought on this video. This is the biggest thing of this presentation for me. It was unexpected for everybody. PAYDAY 2 coming to the Nintendo Switch. Now, as far as we know, we don't know if it's gonna be a definitive version, but it does seem like if we do get it, it probably will be full price. And I don't think anybody's gonna pay $60 for that. Unless it's the definitive version, but even then, that's kind of pushing it, considering the amount of years it's already been out. It already came out on PlayStation 3, it already came out on Xbox 360, it's already been on the PC for a while, especially on Steam. So I don't see why people want to pay a big price for it if they already have it on the other console. So hopefully they can find out a way eventually to showcase they're going to have, like, maybe some exclusive content, maybe some exclusive Nintendo-based mask in there to probably throw in, like, maybe, for instance, The Legend of Zelda, probably throw in the Majora's Mask or something like that, or maybe a mask that represents Mario, or a mask that represents Link, something like that, you know, just little goofy stuff like that. That type of stuff would actually be like, okay, it's worth getting, you know, and maybe some other new exclusive missions, etc., right, because the fact that it is coming on the Nintendo Switch. Now, one of my biggest things about this, will Nintendo owners buy it? Some. Not a lot, but some. And that's the problem, but I'm going to go into another video about that, so stay tuned for more. But that's the thing. I'm just going to say, will Nintendo buyers own it? You can put that in the comment section below. You can answer that. But anyways, that's all I want to